British Columbia has done something no one else has done before. It is the first government at the provincial, territorial, and state level in North America to take 100% responsibility for the emissions from all 128 of its public sector organizations.
In British Columbia, we take climate policy really seriously, and we have for more than a decade. So when BC introduced its first climate action plan 10 years ago, people were convinced that our economy would shrink because of our aggressive climate action. What the carbon neutral government program and our other climate action programs have demonstrated is a decoupling between economic growth and climate action. The BC economy has outpaced the other provinces since 2010, and we have at the same time cut emissions. The first success factor is that we've included all of our public sector organizations. That includes the schools, the colleges, the universities, the hospitals. We ask everybody to count, reduce, and then offset.
Where we couldn't reduce emissions immediately, we followed that up with the use of carbon credits that were generated in a way that involved Indigenous people in British Columbia and the Great Bear Rainforest in a conservation initiative that both preserved tremendous biodiversity in old growth forests, sequestered carbon, and at the same time provided for economic well-being for these nations.
Another important consideration is that we publicly report on all of our emissions. And that way, there is public accountability. A third component is that we are responsible for spurring innovation across the economy.
The government introduced the policy in 2007 to certify all provincially funded projects to LEED Gold. And it really changed how the industry approached building construction here in the province. It had a huge impact. It's become a normal practice to build buildings to that level of sustainability.
We've learned from others, we've been inspired by others. In turn, we're happy to be a model of the right way to do things from an environmental and an economic perspective.